Consider two charged spheres A and B. Both are isolated spheres. Both are having same radius, and the distance between the two spheres is R. Both are having charge Q. Then force between these two in vacuum is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q square by R square. Further, when uncharged sphere C is kept in touch with the sphere A, net charge on both become Q by 2. So now the sphere A has charge Q by 2 and the sphere C also having charge Q by 2. If it is placed in between sphere of charge Q exactly in the middle, means then this distance between AC is R by 2 and C and B is R by 2, because distance between A and B is R. Since the sphere C is placed exactly in the middle, so that distance between AC and BC equal to R by 2. So force on third charge when placed in center of the first two is nothing but consider third charge, force of third charge F3 equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Force between these two is nothing but Q into Q by 2 by R by 2 whole square minus the force between these two, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by 2 into Q by 2, so Q by 2 whole square by R by 2 the whole square. So we can take the common term 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. So we can get 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q square by R square into 2 minus 1. So if we simplify these two means, we can get 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q square by R square 2 minus 1 is nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q square by R square into 1. So Q square by 4 pi epsilon naught R square. This is nothing but the force between A and B before touching the spheres A with C and placed in the middle. Even though a sphere of particular sphere, conducting sphere, is placed between these two, there is no change in the force. That is the final conclusion.